It's a live look. It's a live look at Walmarts around the country.
Look, everybody, it's the last remaining one up at your local Walmart. It looks like rats ate the box.
Wow. Is this the future of arcade one up? Is this the downfall?
Look at it. It's so sad, isn't it?
Yeah. Hey, let us know if you can hear us. Okay, guys, we are using a free StreamYard tool, and we're doing this for a reason because we're going to be giving away something, and we have to use StreamYard to do the giveaway at the end. What's up, MSU Rich, everybody? And what was I going to say about this? So let us know if you can hear us okay equally, yeah, or testing, if one of us has to go up and down. Hey, what, Kev, what is this? This is the old Pac-Man too. This isn't even the new one.
This is one that's been around at my local Walmart for at least 2-3 years. It just sits there. It doesn't play. It turns on, but you can't use it. They rip the joystick apart. And every time I go, I'm just waiting for the day that this is completely gone. So today I looked. I was like, oh, it's still here, and the box got tore up. Let's just take a picture of the future of Walmart. Oh, there it is, guys.
It looks terrible, guys. It's terrible. Not looking good for you 1UP fans.
No, it's
What's
not.
What's up, Brooklyn? Paul, how are you guys doing today?
Brooklyn.
Okay. What do we got to talk about today? We got to talk about three things, guys. We're going to talk about Golden Tee. They lied to us all, okay? Those SOBs, incredible technology, Kev. We're pissed. We're pretty pissed off at them. Okay, this is serious, too, guys.
How could they do this to us?
to us. They pulled an arcade one up on us.
We're the Shilly Willies of Golden Tee, and they screwed us. Oh my god.
Yep. Okay. It looks like Kev froze. That's
now they're
okay.
saying they.
As long as your audio comes through, that's all we care about.
Hold on, they're saying selecting my webcam, Mike. Let's see.
Oh, you might have selected different. Mike, it does sound a little different. So.
Yeah, I got it. Hold on.
You're screwing with us.
Testing. That's better.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
So the second thing is Atgames. Atgames NOD. We got to talk about that, Kev, right?
Yes. Oh, the gift that keeps on giving. Atgames sales.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And then third is we're going to go over the cabs that destroyed 1UP and destroyed John D and got him fired. Here's what we did. I put a list together of 5 and an honorable mention. And Kev's got his list, and we're going to see if they match exactly, okay? Yeah. We know a couple of them for sure are going to match. We know that, but we're going to see if a couple of them match specifically, okay? And if we can get all 5. Okay. Now, let's take a look at this Golden Tee bullcrap, Kev. I'm going to preface it with this. Hold on, let me move this. Explain to them what news came out, Kev.
Right,
Explain what this is here so you guys know what happened.
All right. So in order to understand this, you know, everyone knows Golden Tee. Golden Tee refreshes their hardware every so often. So in 2007, Rexer, that's when Golden Tee Live came onto the scene. And so Golden Tee Live is the Golden Tee that you see in bars today. So in 2022, they refreshed the line where they made a brand new pedestal. They were sponsored by PGA, the actual PGA Tour. And so they created a new hardware version. And so what happened was they broke the platform in two between the PGA and the Golden Tee Live. And the PGA got courses and DLC and different modes that the Golden Tee Live users can't get. And so we as Golden Tee Live users, Rexer and I, we asked Incredible Technologies, can we upgrade to this without buying a $5,000 pedestal?
Can we upgrade to PGA Tour in a few years or whatever?
Yeah.
That was the question asked a while back.
Yes. And they told us unequivocally, you cannot. The PGA Tour does not want Rexer and myself upgrading our old pedestals for a variety of reasons. And
But Kev, you're lying. Did you come with receipts that they said no? Did you come with receipts?
This is the Rexer show.
This
we
is the
always
Rexer
have
show.
Receipts.
We come with receipts on this.
Yes, we do. Look at this chat. It says, will the Golden Tee conversion kits be offered for the existing platform, which is the Golden Tee Live platform? And they say no.
No.
No plans to offer these kits in the future as part of the partnership with the PGA. We have mutually agreed to offer these upgrades through new cabinets only. So you're like, so what's the problem? They told you. This fact was out a year ago.
They told us we couldn't convert. So what did people do? They went out and bought the PGA because they didn't think they could convert their old ones to a PGA Tour edition. And then sure enough, Kev, They get
this. What is this? What is this? So
this news right here that we just showed. You can now upgrade your old Legacy Edition with a kit where you get all new hardware. You know, basically you get the chips that you need, you get the control panel, and you just dump it into your existing unit.
So they lied blatantly. And to make matters worse, chat, that FAQ that we just showed you that I clipped, they deleted it from their website.
They deleted it.
If you go to their website, this clause is no longer on their website. They got caught and now they're running and hiding from the public. And everyone wants answers on why they made a decision to buy the new PGA Tour based on this statement. And now they deleted this statement. So they're getting destroyed right now.
It is scummy and they're getting destroyed, Scepter. Damn you, scummy. IT. I think you meant IT.
Yeah, Incredible Technologies. Yep. And so they're running scared. My guess is sales of the new PGA Tour is not going well, and they want to bring the old users up into the new platform, but they realize they had to lie. And so now they're in trouble.
Yeah, this is a one-up move, really. No more available. We're not making any more.
Everybody buy them.
I mean, this is pretty. This is what pieces of crap Incredible Technologies is. Now, here's the thing, Kev.
If
you were a person who upgraded and bought the $6,000 PGA and maybe you sold yours, okay, this conversion kit is still extremely costly, is what they're saying.
Yes. Yeah. So this conversion kit is $4,000. So not only did they lie to us as the community as huge Golden Tee fans, but they overpriced this thing. Yeah. So they're getting hit on all sides right now.
But that's the only saving grace for people who sold theirs and bought one for $6,000. They're like, because if this thing came out and was like $2,000 or $2,500,
we'd be buying it.
We'd be buying it and people would be pissed. But it's supposed to be about $4,000.
Yeah, $4,000.
And that, you know, that's kind of the only saving grace for people who upgraded thinking they couldn't go back to, you know, get a kit and upgrade. So, So still expensive.
Yeah. So basically, but what he's saying is that there's exclusive courses that Rex and I can't play. They're real life PGA courses. And basically that was the first upsell. Like, you can play real courses. You buy this product. The problem is those courses, nobody plays them. They're boring. They want the freaky courses. They want the real, you know, made up courses that Golden Tee's known for. Yeah. So sales aren't good. And so now they have to scramble to get sales. The community's in an uproar. Everyone wants heads to roll. So
And I think like Mueller says, $2,500 is reasonable.
Yeah.
You know, for an upgrade. Because all you're getting really is the control panel.
That's it.
And the chip. Yeah. You know, and your hardware pretty much can run it, I'm pretty sure. Yeah. But
and what
give
did
you
we
probably
say?
A new SSD or whatever, a new hard drive, and you swap that out. And
we said $2,500, and we probably have an order placed today.
Yep.
Like that's not a problem. But $4,000 for just the top and a chip and a drive, I don't think that's worth it. Maybe they had to do that, Rexer, to price it out so the PGA owners don't revolt and say, I would have just kept my Golden Tee and upgrade it in a year. So you have there's two warring factions. You have the people that own a PGA that says, screw you, Golden Tee Live owners. And then you have us saying, you told us we would never upgrade. I spent $5,500 and now you're saying I could have kept my Golden Tee and eventually I could have upgraded when the price comes down.
Yeah, because we have like one, maybe two more years of upgradable courses and play on our legacy. You know, we just call them legacy. I don't think that's what they call them, but
But we'll never lose what we have. The main thing that's going to go away is the possibility of keeping our persistent stats, the servers.
Yeah.
As long as they keep the servers, it doesn't matter if we get new courses.
IT
we
net.
Have 110. IT net has to stay around. We have 110 courses. We're never going to get bored of them.
Right.
And that license must be real expensive. And on top of that, the PGA license is very tame. If anyone knows Golden Tee and knows the stuff that you can put on your character, you can't do that with PGA.
Yeah.
They have the stuff that Rex and I have unlocked playing the regular Golden Tee. You can't do that. So people are upset.
Yeah.
You got to pay for some of that stuff.
Let's talk about Atgames. Let's move on. Screw Incredible Technologies. They don't deserve our coverage anymore.
No,
those POSs.
Done. But we hit them all, Rexer. As much as we love Incredible Technologies, we'll call it where it needs to be called. F them.
Yeah. F them for doing this, you know?
Yeah.
Good for us, I guess, in the long run, but who
yeah.
knows?
Yeah.
All right. What do we got with Atgames? So those people who tell them what's going on with Atgames, Kev.
Oh my God. Where do we start? So yeah. Congratulations, Atgames. National Owners Day was this week and they celebrated you, the fans.
What a National Owners Day.
It's like Donut Day and Pizza Day, a made up day. All this means is you get overinflated sales and promises that wasn't delivered. So what am I talking about? The day was meant to be happy. You were going to get all your pinball packs, but the servers crashed. The first day of Nod, nobody got their pinball packs. The second thing that people are mad at, these prices. They must get a dartboard, Rexer, and throw it, and that price is the price. Yeah. They are not consistent. For example, the arcade control panel was literally $100 at Christmas. Now it's 180 plus 20 shipping. How can a product double in price in less than 6-7 weeks? It doesn't make sense. The third thing is the Gottlieb tables, RIP Gottlieb. They're not being released on time. They now are going to be released at a later date to be determined, maybe March, maybe April. But good news for your troubles. You get $5 credit, Rexer.
$5 credit. Do we want to start with Gottlieb? Let's start with the Gottlieb tables.
Yeah, start with the Gottlieb tables.
All right. So tell them, I don't even know about what this Gottlieb deal is. Tell them what the Gottlieb thing is. I got to bring something up here. And
yeah. So the Gottlieb the Gottlieb tables were supposed to come out, but they seem to make all these announcements and back them up to National Owners Day so they can release all the tables that were ready on National Owners Day, which means Zachariah, the Dr. Seuss, the Tato tables, and the Gottlieb. And the Gottlieb tables, a lot of people wanted to see what these 4K Gottliebs would look like because there are a lot of Gottlieb fans out there. I'm a fan too. But last minute, and I think, Rexer, on the day they were supposed to release, you can buy a foot long with that. On the day the Gottliebs were supposed to release, they made the announcement. It's not ready. Yeah. It's not ready. And it's like, oh, it's not ready. That's great. They're going to not release something that's not ready, right? Is that good?
All right. So here we go with the clip, guys. This is from Super Game Room Dudes. Now, I don't understand how you guys watch this stuff when I listen to this stuff. But, I mean, let's play the clip of Mike B. What does he say here about the Gottlieb tables? Now, remember, the Gottlieb tables were supposed to come out this day or even earlier. I don't even know how long they were really supposed to come out, but... whatever. They're supposed to be ready, and they're not. Let's listen.
The Gottlieb games, this has been a point of contention because they were supposed to come out today, so people were pretty upset the Gottlieb games never came out. I know for a fact that they didn't release them because they weren't fully cooked yet. So I actually give Atgames a lot of credit for doing that. It's better to...
What? You give them credit for doing that? Oh, all right. Wait, let's go on. Let's listen some more. Because we got credit. Good job, Atgames. I got to give you credit for not getting your crap ready in time. And we haven't even got to the Snoopy part yet, Kev. We already forgot about the Addams Family, okay? The Addams Family wasn't ready, and we released it. But we've forgotten about that. Yep. But they did a great job with Gottlieb by not releasing them when it's... Okay, let's go.
Wait,
let's hear some more.
Yeah.
Release a, delay a product that isn't ready, then release a product that isn't ready. Because you know how the community would have reacted, especially like after how they reacted when Adam's Family Zen Pinball was at... what was it? Pinball Expo. And everybody was like, even though they said this is a beta version, everybody was like, it's terrible. The pinball machine's terrible. So even though I know people are probably disappointed that the Gottlieb tables never got released today, it's going to be delayed, but it's delayed for optimization and making sure that they're good when they come out. So that's not that big a deal, guys. Gottlieb will be out soon. So it's better they did that than rush them out bad.
Wow.
Wait a minute.
I got to say something here. Why don't you just say, PK, did you hear what I just said? Because I just sucked you off so bad that you should be creaming in your pants after how I just protected you guys. Yeah. Because you know I'm in the influencer group, and I love you, PK. Did you hear that?
Listen.
Now, remember this, Kev.
Yeah.
While back, his buddy Ristalgia was saying when Blitz and Marvel vs. Capcom 2 and weren't ready, he was like, no big deal. Let them come out. They can come out. They can fix it later. Did you hear him going that? Well, why didn't they just release the Gottlieb table? So there's a little lag. Who cares? Yep. They'll fix it later. No, he shut his mouth and didn't say anything. Because this is the most back-ass comp. You're like backwards Twilight Zone. Wait a second. You didn't what happened when Arcade 1-Up did it and came out? You guys didn't crucify them and say they should have waited. Nope. You were like trying to protect them too, saying,
"Yep."
I mean, this is the shilliest stuff like Realm Chat said,
dude,
my whole life.
If you look at the end of that sentence, look at Mike B's eyes. He looks down at his phone, and PK sent him a thumbs up emoji after he said that. I swear, he looked right down, and he's like, "Did I do it?"
Somebody sent me this video. I got to show this video, guys, because it's so funny. I think he related it to Mike B. This is a long time ago, you know, and this is a video, a cartoon. And if you're old school like me, you'll remember this. I might have shown it before long ago, but I don't remember. But this just reminds me of Mike B's, like the little dog, and PK, and Atgames is the big dog. And here, let's see if I can play it.
Hey, you want to dig up some bones for you? Anything you say, Spike? Because you and me is pals. That's right, ain't it, Spike? Hey, Spike, you want to play ball? Huh? You want to play ball?
Hey, PK, you want to play ball?
PK, what is
you want it? You wouldn't like that. What do you say?
Nah, you wouldn't like that, PK.
No, PK.
How about we chase cars, huh? Does that sound like fun? That wouldn't be no fun.
Wouldn't be no fun.
How about beating up a cat? Would you like that, Spike? Huh? Would you like that, huh, Spike?
Cat? You know where is it, a cat?
Oh, God.
Yeah, sure, Spike. Sure,
PK. Yeah, I'll say that. Would you like me to say that? It's okay that it didn't come out, PK? Yeah. It's so bad. I mean, I can't even believe you, not you guys in here. Who watches this show and listens to him?
There's no consistency.
How do you not throw up in your mouth and go, oh, my God.
There's no consistency, you know? When those pinballs came out from Arcade 1-Up, Mike B bought all three and said they were great.
Yeah.
Right? He didn't say, they shouldn't have released them, get them right.
He didn't say it's like, better if they hold off and don't release them. But when Atgames does it on Gottlieb. Now, did Atgames do it on the Adams Family and hold off, Kev?
Nope.
No? Did he crucify them and said, they should have waited because it wasn't ready? No. But we say, don't pre-order.
Don't pre-order.
And we're see back. If it's ready and buy it when it's ready because you know they're going to do this.
So wise guy PK is like basically the head of Atgames. Yes. And the rumor has it that he pretty much dictates to the influencers what to say.
It's not a rumor. This is what he does. They're in a group chat, with PK, the owner of the company. Okay, this is the stuff we went over last time that they don't divulge.
Yeah.
And PK gives them direction on what to say. He gives them all the information. He tells
code
them
words.
What narrative to do. It's plain and simple. They all know it. They all do. And this was the narrative, hey, we're going to protect you, PK. We're going to say it's good you didn't bring out these Gottlieb tables early because they're not ready. And great for you, PK. We don't talk bad about Atgames because we're all influencers.
We're all influencers. We seem to be the only ones that want to just bring up the other side because they have so many influencers that you don't get the other side. And you might think if you watch these videos, everything's great. Everything's great.
Oh, God. I wonder if PK just laughs and he's like, I got these guys like a puppet,
em.
Just like John D did, the puppet master. Now PK is the puppet. He's the puppet king.
Yeah.
PK stands for the puppet king.
But
he's now the puppet king.
PK,
the puppet king. We've got your name, PK. You are the puppet king.
But here's the thing. He's better than John D. You know why? You don't see him. He runs it from behind the curtain. Yep.
He's like the Wizard of Oz, the Puppet King
of
Oz.
He's the Puppet King from behind the curtain, and no one expects anything else.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. But wait, this guy's in the Snoopy, though, right? Are you going to get in the Snoopy?
Let's go to Snoopy. Wait,
let me move it.
Tell him what's going on with Snoopy, I'll bring up.
So you just heard Mike B say that they don't release things that aren't ready. Well, the Addams Family came out, it wasn't ready, so he already contradicted himself, right? But Snoopy was supposed to come out the same day as Nod, which there were issues. Nobody got their codes, it didn't work, but eventually Snoopy was released. And do you think, Rex or in chat, that this Snoopy table was 100% optimized like we were told? Let's see this.
I don't know why they bring
this.
It up in point 3A in their book if this thing was ready in their document. What does it say?
This is a PowerPoint chat that Atgames put out that they're working on. So this is a roadmap, a patch. And let's look at under the Zen Studios. What does it say here? Atgames internal tests show the flipper lag in both Addams Family, and Snoopy. This is a significant improvement from Pinball Expo. This is not the community's expectations, and we are working hard with Zen Studios. But wait a minute. We were told that Snoopy was going to be perfect.
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 Perfect. It was already running perfect, Kev.
It was perfect.
Wait, wait, and do we have receipts for that?
Yeah. How do we know it was going to run perfect, chat? Well, we have receipts. Put it up, Rexer. Let's show everybody how we know.
Can you talk about, like I don't, here's what I want to, while I'm putting this up.
Yeah.
When these guys say, oh, it's got 80 milliseconds of lag, and don't pay attention to that. Just don't pay attention to any, because it's all bull crap, okay?
Yeah.
If the thing is comparative to Adam's Family and they're comparing the lag to Adam's Family, you have a problem. You have a problem. Big problem.
Yes.
All right.
Yes. But we were told.
Let me share.
Yeah. So now we're going to show you where we were told Snoopy is going to come and be amazing. And by the way, guys, Snoopy's a $5 table from the Apple Arcade many years ago. It should run on an Nokia N-Gage. It should be no problem to get this thing up
this thing
running.
Runs on your phone fine.
It runs on your phone. Exactly.
Jeez, here we go. Hold on.
Specifically, it is with the Addams Family table that's causing so many problems. But it looks like the Addams Family has a unique situation where it's going to be the worst performing. That's the problem, though, because it's the first one we saw, right? So we are working, we will have more Atgames news and posts in the future, including Pinball Bites, which is our periodic YouTube show covering news, game updates, and general happenings at Zen. Let me know if you have any other questions. So really nice to see Mel Kirk actually show up in this group, show support for what they're doing. Yeah. And
now,
you know,
that was Mel,
me
though.
As,
let me pause it. Do you want me to keep going?
Yeah, well, he's reading a post from Mel Kirk, everybody, in the private Atgames group. Somebody asked Mel to come out and talk about this mess that Zen, you know, Studios is in. And Mel stepped up and he gave a PC answer. And what he says here, if you look, he says here that the Addams Family is a special case. See that right there? Special case.
But he's talking about Zen, but that's not, if you watch the whole thing, they say Snoopy runs fine. Snoopy runs fine. Because Snoopy isn't Mel, right? I mean.
No, it is. It's Zen Studios.
It is Zen.
Yes.
Okay, I thought that was completely Zen. See, that
shows
you how much I know.
I know. No, but that's why they said Addams Family is unusual. Snoopy's going to come out.
YouTuber and influencer looking at this. As a consumer, I look at this, and this reassured me, too. And I was like, you know what? They got this. Zen Studios are going to stand by this product. They're going to work with them.
This.
We're not going to get that one update we got with Arcade
Mall. Oh, God. I can't believe this stuff. Like,
guys, when you're playing your Addams Family and the lag sucks, just go, we got this.
We got this. We got this. Everything else runs fine. Everything else.
Yeah, Snoopy's
fine.
But
it's just Addams Family.
We got this. As
how
can
you guys put up with? I mean, at what point do you guys say, you know what?
Enough.
Why don't you guys just say the Earth is flat? Because I don't even listen to you guys anymore. You know, holy smokes! You know,
and they quietly, Rexer, put Snoopy in that patch list. Quietly put it on next to the Addams Family, which tells you they know it wasn't up to standard either. And if you can't get Snoopy running, You better have concern for Star Trek and Attack from Mars and all the other tables that are coming your way.
Yeah. So you got Snoopy doesn't run right, Addams Family. You got Gottlieb not out. You got a whole list of crap that still isn't working, Kevin. Do you have more stuff listed?
Well,
I don't know.
Put that thing up because that was just Zen. You have the other things in this. Look at all this. So there's rumors that there's tilt problems. People's tables are randomly tilting all over the place. The arcade panel isn't working on some people's units. It works when it wants to. Atgames is aware of it. There's all these little issues, and these are growing pains with the machine. But here's the thing. Why would you want to be part of a $2,000 beta tester when some of this stuff is self-inflicted? Some of this stuff should have not been released in the state it's been. My guess is this stuff should have come out March or April. The pre-order should have not been in November when they did it. They should have been working on this stuff through the new year and then opened it up. But you know what, guys? Money talks. They needed an influx of cash. So they put the pre-orders out in November. Everybody jumped on it. What did we say? If you were in our chat, you know we said, just cool your jets and wait. There's no reason to jump on a pre-order when most of these have Atgames. Most of these have the HD with all your tables, but everyone now is mad. But You can't be mad. You bought this at $15,000. You are now in the beta tester program. Congratulations. It's an expensive program to be in, but you signed up for this. You took the risk. So we just have to hope. And trust me, I want this to work. I want to buy a 4K pinball, but not now. Maybe in a year when I can just turn on and play without, you know, feeling the frustration that everyone in this chat who has 4K kind of feels like. And that's not even talking about the damaged units that's going on around the country. And we can't figure out why Atgames is shipping these units out. I just went on a huge tirade.
I mean, there's so many things.
Yeah, I just went on a huge tirade.
Kev, what do we hate to say?
Never. Well,
I told you so, but we told never you so.
That's what I said. If you, Rexer, if you bought this at 2K and you watched our stream, it's your fault. You're an expensive beta tester now. Yeah. Congratulations. Yeah. You know,
this is the one shining moment that they have right now.
That kit is pretty good from what people say. So the kit sounds amazing, you know, when you get it, like all the other tables play, Carl. So I think Joseph says it here. They rushed it. And I just told the chat, Rexer, I think they should have waited to like March of this year to take your money. They should have been pumping it out. Yeah. Don't take your, like, it's so half baked right now. Yeah. So, and then.
Okay. Are we ready to go to the main topic?
Yeah. Yeah. I just let it out there. I got to drink. Sorry.
You guys heard it. Great NOD. National Owners Day was a complete flop, and go figure.
See you next month for the March sale that they would inevitably have.
Okay. What do I want to
share? All right. Let's get to the fun stuff.
Let's get in the fun stuff. All right. So here's the deal. Before we start, I got a list of five 1-up cabs that I think were their downfall. Okay. I'm going to list them off. We're going to see if Kev matches and doesn't match. But I got one that I left off the list that I wanted to put on, and then I got one honorable mention. So the one I wanted to put on the list that I left off was really not a bad cab or a downfall, but it has a certain thing about it that I think really stopped a lot of people from liking arcade 1-ups, okay? So when we talk about this list, yes, it's mainly, you know, which ones killed John D and got him fired.
Yeah.
Yes, it's mainly that. But it's also which ones were so bad that it didn't matter whether John D was involved or else it could have got it got him, you know, terrible, just, you know, aura about the whole company, you know, whatever it was.
Yeah.
So the one I left off the list and didn't even make honorable mention was Outrun the sit-down kit.
Oh, okay.
Now, the reason I say this is because the Outrun sit-down cab looked so silly when a grown adult played it.
It was so bad.
I think that a lot of people at that point in time said, oh my God, these things are kids' toys.
They've lost the plot.
It hit them in the head when they saw themselves sitting down and playing these things on a bench with this, you know, little, you know, steering wheel and little screen. And I think when it came out, that's why they said, if we do any racers anymore, we're not doing sit-downs.
Yeah.
Because you look stupid playing them.
And Ridge Racer was stand-up only. We didn't get any other sit-downs.
Fast and Furious was you know. But I think, I feel like that cab, like, made people, it kind of, you know, woke in the you know, oh my God, these things are just toys, and they're ugly. I'm not buying anymore. So I left that one out. Now, here's my honorable mention.
Yeah. Okay?
Attack from Mars Pinball.
Oh.
Honorable mention that this one really hurt the company and John D.
It hurt me. I pre-ordered that. I bought that. I was an idiot, but
And the reason I'll just say is, listen, it was complete garbage. We know that now. It was complete garbage, and it was almost the downfall of them stopping and making pinballs. They were not lucrative for them because they didn't sell. They didn't sell like they should have.
Yeah.
A lot of people bought them, but they hated them. They were like, this is garbage, and they'll never buy another one because of it.
Yeah. It was the last one to come out.
And they had to pay for those tables. They had to pay for that license, right? It was so bad. Remember, they had the Universal they were going to do. They had all these tables, all these pinballs they were going to do. But then it came out, oh, my God, this Attack from Mars was horrible. People don't even like it. Nobody's going to buy another one.
Did I ever tell you the story that I actually pre-ordered that? It was when I was in my stupid days, right? And it came into the house, and I didn't open it. I wanted to see what the community thought of it. And once it came out that it was no good, I waited for a patch up until the last day I could take it back. So no patch came. I took it back to my Best Buy, and they told me, Rexer, to my face, we can't take this back. We don't sell this. Look at this. And then I pulled my receipt out, and they're like, what is this? They're like, throw it in the back. They had no idea what this thing was. They took it because I had my receipt. They were like, we sell this? What is this? It was crazy. And then I kind of woke up. It was crazy. I was let down by that because they were finally doing licensed tables. Like it was the Williams tables. We wanted these tables to work, Rexer. I mean, I haven't fully like turned on them yet for being who they were at the time. I thought there was still hope for the
Mars.
You
thought there was hope. Look at Spellgood calling you out like he should.
Call me out.
Dumbass pre-ordered.
But I didn't open it. I just kept it in the corner because you couldn't get one. They sold out from Best Buy within seconds. Yeah. But I didn't open it. So I'm just a half ass.
Now, do you have an honorable mention?
Yeah, I do. I have five cabinets like you. And then I have an honorable mention. My honorable mention, and this is no particular order, is the Tron cabinet. Why is it the Tron
cabinet?
People
love the Tron, Kev. It's great. Well, it was a great.
People love the Tron, but it has two inherent flaws. The first flaw, the stick broke. It only had two games. But the biggest reason I'm calling this out is our boy Glenn Palmento. This started the community looking at John Dee in a different light when he started acting like a child over this Tron cabinet. Remember, he took over Glenn's page, basically.
And that's a good point. Yes.
And it was this cabinet that turned a lot of people against John, and they did not like what happened between him and Glenn, and it persisted until John left the company. So I put Tron on there basically because the stick broke, but it was the outlying relationship that deteriorated between him and Glenn, and it never ended.
So now, here's what I think about Tron. I'll take a little different angle.
Okay.
Nobody cares about Tron. I'm sorry. Besides people who are watching this. Yeah. You could go to anybody down the street and go, hey, have you ever played Tron arcade? They'd be like, Tron, I know the movie, but you're saying it had an arcade.
Yeah, the game?
People didn't give a crap. Oh, yeah, the Arcade 1 that made this Tron, and it looks exactly like it. And it's probably one of their best designs ever. And, it still sucked from a quality, and the stick and the wood and all that. And it looked great. But nobody gave a crap about Tron except you guys, know? I'm not saying it's not a good thing. Sure, Tron was cool for gamers, arcade gamers, but that's not what sells units, Kev. Tron is not a popular unit.
It's not
but guess
a unit
who convinced
seller.
John to convince them to do it?
The community.
The community. We want Tron.
It's Disney.
It's so
you have
beautiful.
Disney? Go get it. Yep. So that's my
good
honorable
one. Good one.
Yeah, I like that one. All right. So do you want to start
list,
with yours? All right.
I got a list. We're going to go through my list. I actually got a little video here to kind of add some suspense to it. Let's look at number five, okay?
All right, let's do it. Oh! Okay.
KI and KI Pro.
Now,
that's number five on my list.
Do you want me to say if it's on mine, or do you just want to go through
it? I want to know, is that on your list?
That is my number one.
And wow.
That is my number one downfall, and we'll get to it.
Wow. No, that's not even close to my number one, but well, let's talk about it. Wait, let me go first. This is my list.
Do it.
This resembles Tron. Nobody besides you guys played Killer Instinct, okay?
Yes.
They made all these Killer Instincts thinking how great and popular it would be and soon found out that the general public doesn't care about Killer Instinct. Okay. They don't care. Then they come out with this Pro because the community convinced them, get the Pro, right? And it sucked. It was horrible. The joysticks were horrible. They still use the same crappy half-inch particle board. The graphics were cut off. There were other things wrong with it too. I think it sat too low or something. I don't even know, like a control panel. But once they did that, Kev, they discounted all the other ones because they had made way too many to try and convince people, hey, buy one of these two. We just need to sell these things.
Yep.
And when the KI Pro was such a failure that they went, John Dee, why did you even convince us to make a Pro?
So that, now do you want to talk about my point of view on the Pro and why?
Yep. Let's get this $2. Thank you,
Jersey Retro. What's up, Jersey Retro?
Very much appreciate it. Thank you.
Appreciate it, Jersey. Here's why I put this so high on the list. Because this John Dee, I picture John Dee going into Scott B's office and saying, Scott, we got to give the community what they want. They want better this. They want better that. We're going to do it with KI. We're going to make it a Pro. And Scott's like, what the hell is a KI? What the hell is a Pro? And John's like, I'm going to make a line of Pros. We're going to sell this And then we're going to backdoor into a Street Fighter Pro, a Mortal Kombat Pro. And he laid out all this stuff. This is what in my head, right? And what happened? You didn't get a Street Fighter Pro. You didn't get a Mortal Kombat Pro. You got a discounted KI Pro that nobody bought.
Nobody wanted it.
His neck on the line for the community to go get this Killer Instinct, higher buttons, a higher mat, all this stuff. And guess what? The community said, we good, John. We'll just take the $299 regular version that you discounted on the same day you put the Pro on pre-order. It was a disaster.
And here's why, too. KI came out right before Mortal Kombat 3. And Mortal Kombat 3 was the last of the Mohicans kind of in the arcade. It was done after that, right? Yeah. So they were on the arcade, fighting games in the arcade were on the outskirts already. It was done, you know?
Yeah.
And what did you get? You got one KI release on Xbox, right?
Yes.
And KI 2.
Yes.
And that was it. The whole, what do you call it, brand, or the whole, you know, genre of that KI brand, that was it, you know, for 10 more years or whatever it was, 15, I don't even know how many.
So KI effectively killed the pro concept for John D, and he was told, you're not doing a pro ever again. And that's why I think it's one of the biggest failures ever, because John was going to be the savior of the community, giving you Street Fighter Pro, Mortal Kombat Pro, and he never got past the first week of a KI pre-order Pro.
And then Hobby Hands, great, glad you reminded us.
Yes.
The 150 KI fail, and they gave you a virtual handshake.
It was like,
hey, we screwed
off.
You on this or something. What was that? I forget what they screwed you on, but they put it on sale.
So what happened was they put it on sale for 150. Everybody went to buy it. It was sold out. A day later, they were all back in stock at the regular price. Yeah.
They said, hey, we sold out of these. Sorry, nobody can get. And they were canceling orders. They were canceling people who had got the sale price. What a disaster that was. The short-term memory out of these arcade one-up shills is just incredible. It's incredible, their selective amnesia, so they can shill these products.
Yes. So that's why I put KI so high. It ruined the reputation of John D. inside. Oh.
Any other licensee, Leo would have.
Any other license?
I don't know why. Who sold them on KI? I don't know.
That's the problem. I would have done Street Fighter. I would have done Mortal. Anything but KI. It made no sense. John, in my opinion, probably pushed it, and that's why it's his failure, and that's why I put it up there so high, because it was such a laughable decision.
Are we good for the next one?
Like it. All right.
Let's go. Number two. Let's get this off.
Oh, wait. I'll get. Okay. Oh, that's why. Yes.
Simpsons.
Yes. Got it. That's my note.
Simpsons was so big. It was the biggest thing to come out, according to all the one-up shills. This was the cab that was going to be the greatest thing since sliced bread. And you want to know why, Kev?
Why?
Because everybody was like, we want beat-em-ups. All these shills were like, we want beat-em-ups. And they had no clue what a good beat-em-up was. Yeah. But they knew of the Simpsons, so they all said, Simpsons, we want the Simpsons beat. We want Simpsons.
Yeah. And what did we say? Do you want a beat-em-up? You're going to play three times?
Yeah. The beat-em-up you play three times with a bowling game that is so bad, you know, that nobody wants to play it anyway. And that's all you got was Simpsons and bowling.
And you could bowl 300 on bowling within your third game.
Within your third game, you figured out how to bowl 300. It was 300 every time.
Every time.
And what about the cost?
Oh, so this was one of the biggest cabinets at 600. I think this was a $600 cabinet.
600 at least. Right, guys? In the chat, it was 600.
It came with a tin sign and a stool. Remember that? That's what you were getting for your 600. It was embarrassing.
And we have no idea how much they paid for the license. We said, Kev, don't pre-order. This will be on sale shortly. And what happened?
Oh, $50 at some Walmarts. The biggest crime was that Walmart was on the hook for all these cabinets they discounted that took up all their room. They were on sale, Rexer, I think within 6 weeks at like $199. Then it went to $99. Then some people were posting pictures at $49. This is at the time, Rexer. At the time Simpsons came out, this was the biggest failure that they've had at that time.
Right.
It probably sent a signal up that says, who greenlit so many of these? Yeah. And it probably went back to John. John saying, Simpsons, print money. It's a license to print money. And it was a license to burn money, but yeah. It wasn't a license to print money. I can tell you that.
Here's what people don't understand again.
Yeah, they were 50
If I
bucks.
Walked down the street and surveyed 100 people and I said, hey, are you aware there's a Simpsons arcade game? 98 would say no, never heard of it.
Yeah.
Never
yeah.
Heard. If I asked exactly. my brother, anybody in my family, or any, you know, any non-gamer, right, who's not yep. in the, and I said, hey, there's a Simpsons beat 'em up that was in the arcade. Do you know it? No. They'd be no. like, no, never heard of it.
Yeah.
So you would have to buy it based on your love for Simpsons.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
if you didn't know there was an arcade game.
It would have then to be you get that it. Game.
Well, then you get it and you realize it sucks. It was horrible. The sound was bad.
Yeah.
The joystick was in the wrong position. I
you
think there was even some marquee
Homer.
Problems.
Remember?
Couldn't play as Homer. Yeah. I mean, this was just a disaster.
And that was the start. That was the first time that I believe 1UP got slapped in the face with reality about managing their licenses, managing expectations. Because, Rexer, I think at that time, we were still in the middle of COVID money coming in, and they didn't have to deal with a disaster like this. Simpsons was their first real failure. And yep. And I think they did not know how to react, because we got much bigger failures after that. Yeah. Much bigger failures.
Mike Hart says, and another, and I
yeah,
think Riddle said
seven.
It was $6.99. Holy
That's
smokes.
Insane.
And
Can
I
you imagine?
Remember, guys, do you remember P-Dub leaked The Simpsons and then he got all worried? And
yeah.
I kind of made
yeah.
fun of him. I'm like, yeah. P-Dubs, nobody cares that you leak Simpsons. You're not going to jail over it.
Yeah,
just leak
exactly.
The Simpsons. Nobody
exactly.
cares. Nobody cares. Ah, oh, Jersey Retro, another two.
Bucks.
Thank you very much,
Jersey
Retro.
You can almost buy a Simpsons with that if you can find it somewhere. Oh my God!
Was this on your list? Was Simpsons in your five?
This was my number two. I wrote down yeah,
number
totally.
Two. We've already hit your number two
yeah,
and
well,
number one.
The only reason I put it at number two because at that time, 1UP was unstoppable. This stopped them in their tracks because they did not know this was going to happen. And,
okay.
And I think this changed the way that they kind of operated their company after, and it took them down an even worse hole later. Because and we'll get to the other ones, because I think they tripled down after this to get out of the Simpsons hole. And we'll talk about that in the next, probably our next three match or next.
Yeah. When did Simpsons even come out? Because
it was,
like I said, JT says it was popular. I know it was popular as a beat 'em up, you know, with people who like beat 'em ups. Wasn't in my arcades. It just wasn't, you know? So I don't know. I mean, and it's to me again, it doesn't even make my top five beat 'em ups, not even close. But
yeah,
you know, what am I gonna say? I don't know if that's another one, but thank you, Jersey, anyway, for your other $2.
Does Jersey know he's sleeping on his keyboard sending $2 super chat? Wake up, Jersey.
Jersey, you don't have to send a chat, you know, for us to put them in. This ain't other shows. If you just want to send a chat, we'll put it up.
Yeah.
All right, so you want to go to number three?
Yeah, let's do it.
Let's go. I mean, come on, guys. Is this hitting your list? Are these good in the chat? Come on. 1991.
See, yeah, I thought it was 92, 93.
You know,
but 91.
To me, it's a little late. 91, 92, that's Mortal Kombat era, you know. It's getting a little late in the arcade world, you know. So, okay. Number three, Kev.
What do you got? I think we're heading to the same two. Oh, now this
Big
I don't
Blue.
Have.
Did you
Big
forget
Blue.
Big Blue, Kev?
Oh,
is this on your list?
No, this is not on my list.
This I almost thought this one should have been number one that
wow.
destroyed John
D. You're going
Big
Blue.
And the whole company in itself.
Wow.
And Kev, there is nothing more evident of why this was so. Not only was the cab so bad, I mean, the people had to put risers under the risers.
They were doing risers
right?
on risers.
The control panel was slanted. It hurts your hands. It had lag in the offline edition. It had input lag that had to be fixed.
That
had to be fixed by a third party update. That it
wow.
was so bad. The online was so bad and the lag was so bad. It was basically unplayable. It was horrible. There was speaker gate with it. Remember?
That's
speaker
right. Gate? That was
this
horrible.
Was one of the worst cabs ever made. It shook, rattled, and rolled, and it looked like a God-blessed clock. It looked like a grandfather clock and a can opener.
They said that they had nipples on it, some people were saying, because it had wings.
It was so bad. I mean, but that's not that's not why I say it was his downfall, because all their cabs are bad to some point. But Paul, thank you very much, Rex and Kev. Great to see you guys back together.
He wants that giveaway.
Can I please be anti-fatigue mad for MK4?
We have 4,000 KI meds.
No, we got. We'll give you a little giveaway. Just hang in there. You know, it'll be good for all. You know, we're not giving away a one up, so it'll be good for all.
It's good for them.
Yes, and it will be random. But here's the deal with Big Blue, Kev. They couldn't give these effing things away.
Oh,
they could.
God.
They tried to give them away. They gave them away on the charity stream for $150, and even after that, they still had truckloads and truckloads that they were dumping. Somehow, this idiot John D convinced them that people wanted Big Blue, and nobody knows what Big Blue is. There's not a soul on earth that doesn't follow fighting games and arcade cabinets that knows what Big Blue is. So when they walked into a store or online and looked at this can opener, this this like, grandfather this? Clock that was blue and ugly, nobody bought it. Not one person bought it. And why? Because they already had a Street Fighter if they bought it. That looked more like a Street Fighter.
Yeah.
But he convinced these guys to make tens of thousands of these units, and they couldn't get rid of them. It was a big downfall to his career there.
It mirrors the Simpsons. It mirrors like the kind of path that they've started on. It basically is a KI situation. John talked these people that this is the holy grail of fighting, you know, cabinets. But the problem is they already had the Street Fighters. Nobody wanted this because they already had that cabinet. And then they realized it's a disaster. They had to fake sell them at a charity event. For 140, we had people in the community that's no longer here.
Which wasn't
here.
A charity event. Let's not use the word charity because that's against the law.
It did not qualify
legally as a charity event, but they made it off to be a charity event, which to me is very scummy.
Yeah.
Not Arcade 1-Up. Arcade 1-Up made sure not to use the word charity event in any promotion. Remember that, guys.
Yeah, it was
only
the
1-Up shills used the word charity in all their thumbnails and all their stuff. It was not a charity event. I just want to make that clear to everybody.
It was basically a garage sale because their warehouse was overflowing. And I don't know if you're aware, Chat, a lot of people use third-party warehouses and they charge you by the rent.
I got to put this one up. Thank you, Brad, Papa Brad, for the $2, number one arcade chain. He's going live on the Arcade Star Wars Talk after we're done. Yep.
Right.
So we're going to send you guys over there when we're done. Never heard of Big Blue until A1.
Wow.
See?
Wow.
See? That's not unheard of, though, Kev.
Yeah.
That's not unheard of.
Wow.
You know? So that is one of my points. All right. Are you done on that one?
Yeah, I'm done on that. I did not have that one. So we're going to overlap.
I can't believe you don't have that one.
Well, because I don't have it because I don't know. My list, that I have something on here that you might go, just like, you know, I'm doing with Big Blue in the chat, but I'll make an argument. This is we'll get there, but I have an anti-John D unit and you'll see when I get there. But yeah, I don't have it. So I think you and I are going to match on the next two.
Yes, Weez. This was the song that Cogs R Us was. So they made some money.
Yes.
They donated 5% of revenue to charity. But it didn't qualify as a charity event, just so you know.
Yeah. Yep. All right. So what do you got?
Okay. Number two, then we'll do the giveaway. Okay.
Yep. And then I'll have
two.
One that you don't. I know. It has to be good. It has to be. This is the gift that keeps on giving.
Yes. NFL Blitz. This wasn't a hard one. I mean,
this will never end. You and I will be able to talk about this when we're 70 to say, we told them. We got, Rex, do you remember? We got ridiculed by all the shills. They all tried to come for us when we got on stream and said, guys, do not get involved in this. This is going to be a disaster. The late hits are everything. This is not good. And we were attacked. That was a real vicious attack you and I took. And then we made a prediction that it would be on sale for like $199. And we took ridicule. And
oh
guess
my
what?
God. We made a prediction.
We made a prediction.
That this thing would be $200 in a couple months.
It was. I cannot believe it went on sale for $199 on Black Friday when it came out in September. It blew my mind that they ruined the NFL license. So it's no surprise that you got Blitz up there because it probably got John D half his pink slip filled out and it got put in a folder and they were waiting for the other half, which we know what your number one is after.
Here's the funny thing about NFL Blitz is now people are coming out and saying, Well, yeah, it was missing a lot of assets. It didn't have missed a lot of audio. It didn't have the late hits.
Yes.
Some of you can't get make your own plays. Some of the players were missing. The online play sucks. You can't do multiplayer online.
Yes.
All these things they're saying now.
We said, and we got
told you before it even came out, it's going to miss all this stuff.
Yes.
And now all these people are coming out and saying, well, that's why I didn't buy it because blah, 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 blah.
I'm like, where were you? Wait a minute. If I go back in time, you were the one to say, it's going to be fine, Chad. Just buy it. Remember when John was like, I think this is when John said you'd be asked out if you
this
didn't.
This was the asked out cap.
This 100%. Was the asked out cap, guys.
This was you be asked out, and we laughed at him. We said, you know.
Yeah, we said, guys, there's no asked out. No, these asked out.
You'll get one whenever
ready.
You want. It's just, it's hilarious that people, the 170 people, how can we be so right all the time?
We don't want to be
all
right
all the time. Paul says 99.99. I mean, I love going back to this and just proving we were right and how wrong all the shills and all the channels you watch are. They're always wrong. They're wrong about everything. But not the people who watch our show. All those other idiots who have selective amnesia and want to forget about the past, we'll just put it aside and keep going. It's our job to remind you because history will help you prevent the same mistakes in the future, which is what we have tried to do. That's what this is about. We remind you of this because history will prevent you from making the same mistakes in the future, whether it's Atgames or, you know, Joe Schmo's company who's making arcades in the future. We're just trying to help you, okay?
My biggest problem is that these guys rewrite history, that they will casually do a stream and go, oh yeah, no late hits. We didn't like it. Wait, you made 82 goddamn videos telling me to buy this. Who cares about late hits?
I wish I had the video prompted where they were all playing it in their hotel and they're trying to play four players.
Yeah.
And 19K like, Fox is like this, trying to play between three adults.
Like
it was
arms.
The funniest thing I've ever seen. He was squished like a sandwich, just between two pieces of bread, squished, trying to play four players. And they're like, this is fun. This is fun. They're like faking that it's fun. I'm like, that is not fun playing like that.
No.
You know?
And if that doesn't tell you where their allegiances lied at the time, it wasn't with the truth. It wasn't with the community. It was with Arcade 1-Up, guys. Remember this. When when they get on the stream and they go, like Mike B does all the time, oh, you know that Arcade 1-Up pinball game, you know, they stink now. He bought all three, Chet. He shilled the hell out of it. But now he casually forgets that. Just like all these guys casually forget that they sold Blitz to you.
Chandra was Chris Carter.
Chris Carter.
Remember his back was... He couldn't even see the screen. And he's only 6'3". He couldn't even see the screen. And these shills are like, oh, this is great. Yeah,
there's a picture of Dan Marino with like...
They never played it once online. They were going to have tournaments. I'll give somebody credit. It wasn't PD7, but somebody else had a tournament online, and I watched some of it because I wanted to see. And they had a few guys who joined and played a tournament. Now, the connection was pretty poor. Well, I watched a lot of stuttering, but it was. I'll hate to use this word. They made it playable. They got through the games, okay?
Okay.
I noticed some things were kicking, you know, like we said, on the field goals. It was a little rough, and, you know, there was some stuttering and – but they got through it. They got through it. Now, granted, remember, they all had the hardwire and bar bodies adapters and just to even make it playable,
it
which other people don't have.
To get the great put reception.
It, connect it right to your modem. Don't even use a wireless router because that's going to slow it down even more. You got to have gigabit Ethernet. You got to be close to each. So.
And the funniest thing is, and then we'll stop blasting this, I only think it got like two updates, Rexer. I don't even think to this day it plays the way it should. It's horrible. R.I.P. All right.
How many you got left on your list before we move on?
I have two. I have one that you don't, and I think you and I match on your. I know what your number.
We're gonna
one
match
is.
On the last. Yeah. One. So you have one other one.
Yeah. Do you want me to talk about
let's
that?
Let's do the giveaway. Let's do the giveaway.
All right. Let's go. What are we giving away? This.
Hold
am
on,
I
guys. Don't put anything in yet. What do I have to do? I have to put in.
So put in a hashtag keyword.
We're gonna do all caps. Arcade 1-Up. Sucks. Okay.
All right, chat. Do not put it in yet.
Don't put it in yet. Just collecting. Wait. All right. I'm going to start collecting. This is for a $50 Amazon gift card.
Whoa.
Okay?
Holy crap.
And I want to thank, there's some people who donated. I'm not going to say any names, but you know, this is thanks to them. We're going to be giving money back, you know, over the next couple months.
Wow.
In large amounts, actually. We're going to be doing some large amount giveaways.
Would you find a bag of cash on your way home?
Start collecting comments. Go ahead, guys.
All right, everybody. Hashtag A1UP sucks. And we can talk about the one that you don't have.
Yeah, let's hope this works.
Let's see. Well, I don't see anybody typing yet. Let's see.
Yeah, we'll wait and see. I don't
know. Yeah, I think we're 30 seconds
behind.
There we
go. Entries are coming.
Goofy wants a couch kid.
I figure we have 100. We might get 100 entries, Kev, because I'd say there's 75 lurkers and haters that don't want to win and show their accounts on here. But whatever, more the less
fire
people
starter in the chat.
The more
look at all these new names showing up in the chat for your
look
giveaway.
At the new
I
names who
it.
Don't want to comment. But, yeah,
hey, you
hey
can,
for 50
hey,
buck Amazon
take it,
gift card.
Take it. We don't care.
Yeah, but I want to thank the people like the Paul Barris's, you know, even the Papa Brad's,
Paul Barris.
We got a lot of people who have donated over the
Stringer.
Time.
Stringer, I think Stringer donated a whole one up
sure.
to you.
You know, for him, we're, you know, I know I'm missing a whole bunch of people, but you know, just a lot of people have donated over the past couple months. So we want to give something back.
Awesome.
We know that 1UP sucks. Keep putting them in there, guys. We're only at 34. Come on.
Game Broker 84 is in.
We don't care if you're in here. We don't care if you're a creator or, you know.
Corner K can enter.
Corner
I didn't see
K,
it. I don't
go
think
ahead.
He entered. Enter.
You can put Arcade 1UP sucks. I know it kills you to do it.
He can't type it. He's like, Wait, Mike B sucks is not the thing you should be typing. It's Arcade 1UP sucks. You will not win. You will not win with that.
Good. Corner K entered.
Yeah, Corner K, get in there, man.
I'm glad that less people do that. We get more of the legitimate, the guys who love us, you know?
Yeah, the people that are typing this in, right. Let's go.
Yeah. I'm trying to remember some of the
You've never gotten free money by just typing, what, 8 characters? 7, like, come on. 9 characters?
We've had Paul Stringer. I forget half the people that don't.
So
it's
many.
Usually the usual
Unacceptable
stuff.
Fringe
Unacceptable
has just donated.
Fringe, thank you. That's right.
Yep. Brooklyn's going to buy 3 Simpson cabinets, he
Arcade
said. Stock
Talking
is.
Star Wars has donated, you know, so thank you very
T.
much.
T. McCloskey.
Yep.
We got 50 entries almost. Let's go.
Come on. We got to get at least to 60, you know?
Yeah.
There we go, dear. Alfred, you only got to put it in once, Alfred. It doesn't increase your chances.
He can spam it all he wants, but it ain't going to count.
My family, I hope you did it. I hope you got in there.
But only when you watch Ralph play with it, my family. That's that's the
47. No,
no, it'll jump. It like takes a few minutes, I think, for it to update because I see new people typing. But
all right, let's do 69 entries. I hope
69.
All right, over 50. It's too bad, you know. All right, Razor Burn. Right. That's right, buddy.
Oh,
they're
look
doing
at him,
good man. They're
He's trying to get
good.
An extra.
They're coming here. They're coming here to Vegas on March 9th. All right, we get to 50, one more, and then we'll draw.
Guys, people this is 50 people, bucks instantly.
People don't
in
want
your
free money.
Amazon
man, there's a
account.
Lot of lurkers in there.
Yeah. We don't care who it
late
is.
Late to the show, Chris. Well, we're going over the top Arcade 1UP cabs that caused their disaster, and we're trying to do a drawing. So put A1UP sucks,
hashtag
A1UP sucks in the comments, hit enter and you'll be entered in.
And
hurry up and do it because we're going, we're at 50
straight
now.
Straight Amazon gift card. You can be shopping tonight.
We're streaking.
We're streaking.
Yeah. We'll throw some octopi I might have to do that in Vegas here. Get an octopi, throw it on the ice. They're playing March 9th.
52. All right, we got 50s. There you go. Let's see, 53.
We're going. We're not waiting for you guys because we got to finish our list.
All right, everybody. All right. Fingers crossed. It's somebody in this
Here
chat.
We go.
Let's rock.
Let's draw.
Oh, look at those names. Oh, I see them. There's Carl. There's Adam. There's Rich Waddell. Hobby Hands. Oh, my Goofy.
John Jay. Oh, spell good.
Spell
oh, my
good.
Gosh.
There you go.
Unbelievable.
There
this
you
is
go.
Rigged. He always chats for
he
us.
He always chats.
All right. Spell good. We're going to just write therexershow@gmail.com in an email, and then
yep, we got one more.
Don't worry, guys. I think we got one more giveaway, right? Or
maybe,
no?
Maybe. Let's
maybe,
see. We got to get through
hurry.
This thing, okay?
All right.
All right. And I got to get back to Chase. So we're going to do this
all right,
giveaway.
All right.
But we got the last one.
Do your last one. And
ready?
Then, yeah, which we all know.
We kind of know what this last one is.
Yeah, we have to know what this is. Oh my God. This is worse.
That was pretty obvious, Kev. Yeah, you go ahead and start. Go ahead.
Yeah, so after the disaster of Blitz, they doubled down with MVC2 and they came out with worse mistakes than Blitz because this cabinet was not playable. Like, Blitz was sort of playable offline. This wasn't playable offline. This wasn't playable online. No patches came for months. When the online finally came, it was the desert stage only. There was input everywhere. This was a disaster. The fight community was up in arms. The free MVC2 movement, or whatever this movement was, it was a failure. It wasn't adapted by anybody. Even the top fighters came out and was like, we're not playing this. It's no surprise why this is the worst cabinet that Arcade 1UP ever released. It was spurned by everybody. So I don't see this being topped as their biggest disaster. Oh, you're muted.
All right, here we go.
Yeah.
I know you said everything that we need to say.
Yeah, that's all we got to say.
Sucked. The whole thing sucked.
Even when
it came out, it sucked.
Couldn't play it online. Couldn't play it offline.
My whole thing about this is they tried to get all the shills to put this thing out and give it a good thing. But even like Maximilian Dude said it wasn't any good.
All the fighters were like, we're not playing this.
But they did get a couple at Evo, remember, who shilled it. And it was so sad to see them shield it.
It was up in a hotel room.
It was up in a hotel room. And here was the funny thing is all the shills that we know, like the Kongs who was there and the UAGs and the Motes, they all knew that the thing didn't run right at that time. It was known. It was a fact. They knew it and they didn't tell you. They didn't tell you it didn't run right.
Yes.
And they all knew it. They were told by John D to hide it. This thing didn't sell. And the other thing, Kev, I don't know if you said, was they told you it was a limited run and you weren't getting it. All the shills told you. And we said, no. There's no such thing. You will get it. Don't worry. You don't have to pre-order. And what happened, Kev?
Kept making it. And then we have a version of it now. We have the X-Men version of it.
Yes.
Oh, come on. You didn't have to do that.
You got. Thank you, Spell Good.
Let me put that up.
Half of the gift card for that. Thank you. Dragon Field Restoration Budget. Oh, thank you. Canadian pesos.
Uh-oh.
Thank you, Spell Good. Thank you. All right. Woo. I'll take it. And
you
send me that email, therexershow@gmail.com. We'll get you. We got one more. We're going to do it right now.
Yeah.
Well, no, Kev. Give your list. Right, what's your last one?
Okay, so I tried to think outside the box. I picked one that no one would ever bring up. But ready for this? When I say these things to you, Partycade, Projectorcade, Babycade, Couchcade, Countercade, Pac-Man, Ralph Joystick, Casino Cades, and Polar Reboot. They're all failures, right? But there's one cade in this list that I didn't mention called the Partycade. The Partycade was actually a great product. The Partycade actually sold out. So what does John D do? He discontinues it. And he doesn't sell the Defender Partycade, which was actual arcade authentic joysticks. So this is the opposite problem. They could sell a ton of these. These go for $400 or $500 on eBay right now, Rexer, because people want these, and they didn't sell them. So if you're Scott Bacharach and you're like looking on the internet and you're like, John, these are going for $500. What happened? And John's like, I didn't sell them anymore. He's like, what? You got one that sold. Why didn't you sell this? So this was my wild card.
Okay.
It was
more the opposite.
I just tried to think. Yes. They stopped making them.
Interesting.
Everybody wants them. Everybody wants them.
Yep. Okay. How do I get? Let me see if I can get back to the tool.
Go back to the
Chase,
tool.
Please. Okay. We'll do that. Let's share the screen. It's the last giveaway, guys. We're going to do another $50 gift card to Amazon.
Damn.
Yeah.
Round two, guys. Look at this. You thought it was over.
And again, we'll be doing this in the next couple months, but I'm not going to put it in the stream. You know, we want people who just want to show up and listen.
You got to come in and hang out.
So how about Shilly Willy?
Shilly Willy.
Shilly Willy for all our shills out there. They all know who they are. Start collecting comments. Shilly Willy.
Woo!
But yeah, I can go with that, the Partycade. I can buy into that.
Look at the chat.
I actually like the Partycade. I liked it so much. Remember, I did an Atgames. I mirrored my Atgames project
out
of it.
You made your project.
Because I liked the idea so much. I made a Partycade.
Yes.
It doesn't take up room.
No.
You did. The one problem with it was you did have to You did it, and I know because Show Me Retro had one.
Yeah.
It was a little wobbly. You couldn't do it on the door. You needed to reinforce it on the wall.
I put mine on a table. You're right. Know. I didn't really hang it up, but to have Defender that was decently, you know, emulated with the right controls for finally once.
Yeah.
And on top of it, they marked these down on top of not realizing what they had to like $100. I paid like $120 for mine. It was the opposite of stupidity as opposed to not selling something. They were selling something and then put it on sale, then discontinued it. Like, what are you doing? It's crazy. And the chat knows this is the only product that they actually would buy out of our community. And you know, you can't get it.
Yeah.
All right, look at this.
So Shilly Willy's coming,
Shilly
Goofy
Willy, guys,
you can get
go.
In there. We don't discriminate here.
Come on.
You know, this is the last
one. Hobby hands, let's go. Here. Goofy's in. My family's in.
No, but we got to give people the enter. See,
my family's in twice. He's in three times.
Come on, there you go, Keo. Get in there.
Keo's
buddy.
In there.
Get in
let's
there,
go.
Keo. I like it. Retro FSR.
Alfred Burger's in. Let's go.
Yeah. Rexman.
Rexman, is that
I
your
don't
friend
care. Use your alt, you know, we'll yeah, have to yeah. Next time we might have to do like 2 months of subscribers, so you know, don't
can you
don't
do that on the
alt.
Oh yeah, you could do the chat.
Oh
right?
Yeah, like, I can block people for months and we'll do that.
Here we go.
King Ed, they love you, Chase. They're saying, hey,
yeah,
Chase.
Look, this, Rexer, this had Gorf on it, and I love Gorf. It had Gorf on this party gate. Like, come on.
It was a good one, but they don't want to make it. But why wouldn't they keep doing it to, what's that one place again? The
QVC and HSN?
QVC.
I have no idea.
QVC sells more things than anybody.
I have no idea. You know? It's insane.
There's Arcade Star.
Oh,
all right. Go to their show.
The
I don't know.
All
they right. must not have started yet. Right after we do this drawing, we're going to send you off to Arcades Talk and Star Wars. Well, we can't do that. We don't even know how to do that.
We're
Arcade
not part
Talk.
Of that.
We're not part of that shill clan that routes you to one stream to another and make sure that they get
don't
everybody,
leave.
Every viewer. Don't leave. Don't go anywhere. I'm going to route you to Mike B. Then he's going to route you to 19K. And then 19K is going to route you to Carl. And then they're going to reroute you back to Mike B. because he's doing a late one.
And then it'll be Thursday and you're stuck here for a week. Oh my
all
god.
Right, let's all right, draw.
52,
here we go.
Let's go. All right, chat. Fingers crossed. Look at these names.
This is the last one. We got to draw.
Last
winner,
one, Chase. We're almost
come on.
Done.
Oh,
come on. Oh, I saw the
corner
gate.
Richard Mattello. Oh,
Razor.
Oh,
John J.
I don't know John J. too well.
I don't know him too well.
Congratulations.
Yeah. Here we go. Corner gate. You are.
We can't rig this. We try to rig it. We can't do it.
Yeah, we don't rig stuff here, guys.
we wanted to, but John Jay, you know what to do. Write the Rexer show. So close, Corner
Cade. Corner Cade was right there. He missed it by like a name.
all right, let's go back to here.
Right.
Kev,
woo,
say your byes.
Good show. Thanks, chat.
Good show. Hey, leave in the chat what your five are that ruined Arcade 1-Up. I'd love to see the list. Leave them in the comments. Your five that ruined Arcade 1-Up. You know. I think our list was pretty good, right, Kev?
I think we did good. I think that was a fun one.
I think we did great, you know?
Oh, good stuff. All
right. See you. Go to Arcade Talk and Star
Arcade
Wars.
Arcade Talk,
okay?
I'll be there soon, Brad.
If you can put it in the chat, in the comments, go ahead. Somebody put it in the comments, the link. We got to get out of here. Chase
Marine
is going to rip my head
so
off.
Close.
All right. All right. Marine 50.
So close. His name was like right there.
It teases you. It like puts your name
Yeah, it does that one. It just gets you.
All right. We'll
see you guys. See you, Chase.
He said, bye, Chase.
Bye, Chase.